Let's start with the code of conduct now. 7.1.10. Institution has a prescribed code of conduct for students, teachers, administrators, other staff, and conducts periodic programs in this regards. Now, what is expected over here? It is that there is a code of conduct for every stakeholder. Be it a student, be it a teacher, be it the principal, be it an admin, be them the administrators, let them be anyone, they have a code of conduct of how to behave on the campus. Not only that, it should be put up on the website, also on the prospectus. It must be communicated very effectively to the students. Besides the point, we need to conduct some special programs whereby code of conduct is explained to the students and to every stakeholder, giving them a complete understanding as to how to behave and how to live on the campus. It is ideally a process by which we are trying to make our students better citizens. Now, all these aspects need to be considered. A code of conduct for everyone needs to be written and kept on the website. Then we come to something as the 7.1.11. Institution celebrates, organizes national and international days, events and festivals. And a list of it is asked in last 5 years. Objective being that, are you in good connect with the community? Do you have, when we talk about values, what we talked in the previous case, 7.1.10, these values are being represented through the days. When we make a mention of some particular day, for example, an Earth Day or a Environment Day, at that time, when we celebrate it, we are actually inculcating those values again into the children, into the students. We are trying to tell this is important. When we have a day, a Sadbhavana Divas, or when we have Mahatma Gandhi Jayanti, at that time we are actually telling the students to see to it that let us try to understand these values, let us try to live as per these values. So this counts out, and a record of it needs to be kept, photographs of it need to be kept, notices of it need to be kept, and of course, those who were present for it need to be made a mention of. Now we come to the next important aspect of criteria 7, and that happens to be the best practices. 7.2 is about the best practices. It has a huge weightage, 30 marks. 7.1 had 50 marks. 7.2 has 30 marks. The question is, describe at least two institutional best practices as per the NAC format. What does the NAC format say? For first, let us look into it, and then we will look into the best practices. Title of the practice, objectives of the practice in 100 words, the context about the features, the practice, describe the practice and its uniqueness in the context of higher India, of education in higher India. What are the constraints? What are the limitations, if any? About 400 words. Evidence of success. What best practice you have started? What is the way by which you can say that it is a best practice? And what are the targets set up? And what is the benchmark that you have done for? And then what were the problems that you have encountered in this particular aspect? This carries 30 marks. Now, when we are talking about the best practices, there are innumerable best practices that an organization practices. But one is, we need to know that it is a best practice. I would like to share one small aspect over it. For example, Modern College Ganeshkind has a buddy practice. Whenever a student gets recruited, admitted into the college, and if he is from some other part of Maharashtra, a student who is there for the previous years becomes his mentor, buddy, guide for 1 year. For example, there is a student who is coming from Vidarbha, which is quite far away from Pune. Then in that case, some student who is in the second year or in the third year becomes his buddy. He sees to it that he gets a place to stay. He sees to it that whatever problems he has are sorted out. And the biggest part is that the student who is a buddy is from the same area. If he comes from Vidarbha, this boy is also going to be from Vidarbha only. Now this helps him to adjust very happily, very quickly to the needs of the organization. When we are talking of some more best practices, this is a best practice which has been mentioned with respect to admissions. But we have many other practices, n number of practices are possible. For example, I am able to see a best practice wherein an organization provides seed money to the students who want to go for innovations or who are trying to innovate the products. Now, here the organization is actually trying to promote innovations. They could be extremely small, the amount may not be big, but even then it makes a big, big impact. One of the organizations who offers the courses in journalism, they had gone for a best practice whereby they had promoted the students to prepare a video on their own college. Something like 200 entries came in, whereby you are able to see 200 different aspects of the organization could come together. Here you are able to see a final video that was made, projected the college in a very wonderful way. A best practice could even be on a washroom. An organization in Goa, if I am not wrong, it is the Chaubule group of colleges. Washrooms in one of the colleges in Goa, if I am not wrong, it is the Chaubule college. They have created a mechanism whereby the campus is very clean and so are the washrooms. They are maintained to the level that the University of Goa has made a mention saying that if an organization like Chaubule group of institutions or Chaubule college is going to maintain such a level of high level of cleanliness, they can charge extra from the student to see to it that the maintenance costs are recovered. I would like to give one more example which is again related to washrooms only. When you go from Pune to Mumbai on the highway, after we cross Lonavala, there happens to be a restaurant called Datta. They have bio toilets. They do not use water. It is one of the cleanest places with respect to their washrooms. The bio toilets see to it that the waste water that is generated out in this process gets sorted out through the bio toilets, and that water, which is actually the grey water, is now converted into a good water and is used for lawns. You are able to see such practices are expected by NAC. Yet another best practice to make a mention of happens to be a library for the blind. There are organizations who support libraries for the Divyang students. But something very important over here is that with the help of the mentors they have, not only the students refer the library, they have created their own materials which are grammatically correct and are being used in a much better way. Such kind of and many other practices in any area are best practices. A best practice primarily aims at making an organization a better place for working. The word best need not be taken as good, better, best. A best practice can evolve. A best practice can remain in an organization for a very, very long period of time. It is not compulsory that every 2 or 3 years you can change, you need to change a best practice. However, we need to plan for a best practice before we actually implement it out. And we need to see to it that it keeps on improvising out over a period of time. This was about the best practices. We have one more small area which has a huge weightage called as the distinctiveness. An institutional distinctiveness is also a kind of a best practice, but it is distinctive to that particular kind of organization. That's how it becomes a distinct practice. I wish to make a mention of one of the episodes. When we were to face NAC in 2017, we really had a question as to why is it, what is the distinctive practice that we need to make a mention of? And the question came, why is it that students come to us? We are a small college of a campus lesser than an acre. But even then we have something like 5,000 students on the campus. We don't have a beautiful campus. We don't have a very lucrative canteen. But students keep on coming to us. And then we found out, we started asking our students, why did you take the admission to our college? To our surprise, as we went through the list, we found that there are a very large number of students coming from all parts of Maharashtra. And when we tried to look into it, we came to know that they come here because though a good quality of teaching and learning is available, we also happen to have a competitive examination cell which has a very excellent track record of more than 25 students getting into the civil services and into the Maharashtra government services. Now this made a big impact, and then we came to know our distinctiveness lies in this additional service that we provide to the students. There can be a variety of best distinctive practices that you are able to see. For example, a library-centric learning, whereby you are able to see the library supports criteria 1, curricular aspects. Library supports criteria 2, teaching learning. Library supports research. Library supports extension. Library definitely is a part of good infrastructure. Library supports student progression also. And library being maintained very well is an example of good governance. And if you have a wonderful library with respect to environment, you are able to see again it leads to all the 7 criteria. This can still become a best distinctive practice that I wish to make. In other words, when we are looking into criteria 7, it's not only what you have. It's not that whether you have a clean campus. It's not just about having a clean campus. It's not just about having no gender biases. It's not about having environments whereby you are able to see you're saving energy. It's about our attitudes. Environment 7 actually talks about the attitude of the organization. How compliant is it with the environment around? Then it becomes a good organization. Yet another important feature is, are we in a position to understand what is best with us? And how best can we improvise our best is what this criteria deals with. And therefore, to me, this is one of the finest criteria that NAC offers. These are the questions that really make us think about ourselves. All 7 criteria have been completed over here. And I believe it must be a wonderful learning for you, because these are the initial years of your organization. You are going to have long careers. Without NAC, without quality, campus life cannot be beautiful. I know campus life is a word which is used for students, but you are still on the campuses, and therefore campus life also means a lot for the teachers. I am extremely thankful to you for being a part of this program and to listen to me very carefully on my discourses about NAC. I request you to be a part of IQAC Cluster India, which is available here on the presentation. Visit the website and try to get the maximum details out of it. Thank you very much for being over here.